We don't want to let our friends from Southeast Asia know what we're doing. It's a secret still, no, but definitely Team Philippines is now beginning to get increased recruitment program. I'd like to announce that taking on the CDM, or second mission for our Team Philippines for the Games, is none other than our Secretary General, Rob Rosario. I'd like Rob to answer that question, but you know, Rob is a man of few words. But we will definitely try to field as many athletes as we can in the, at least minimum, as I said, minimum 15, 16 sports that we will have. And again, I'd like to thank the Philippine Sports Commission that is very much behind us in trying to make sure that we have the equipment, we have the training facilities that we can use for the purpose of getting the athletes ready. So it's going to be a very challenging task, and I'd like to be conservative in saying that, of course, we went up two notches from the Games in Singapore in 2015. From seventh place, we moved up to fifth place, and we would like to probably target. I think the Philippine Olympic Committee was being very conservative and saying they will target top three. Of course, always number one, but top three. We will target at least top four, because my colleague here beside me, Thailand and Indonesia and Malaysia are very strong countries to be. But that is our goal, to be at least in the top four. And of course, gain more medals, get more medals than we did the last games in Kuala Lumpur.
Mr. Marino, are all the facilities are really for January, including the period that will be used in cycling?
Well, the facilities that are being prepared, I we mentioned, but they are building a new stadium, aquatics and a swim stadium and a track and field, athletic stadium in the new black area, plus dormitories that will serve as the athletes' village. We're hoping that will be ready sometime in the middle of next year. And of course, for our purpose at Para Games, we are making sure we're working closely with the people building these sports venues, that they will be accessible for our para athletes and of course for our spectators with disabilities. So we're making sure of that. And your question was, what was the other question? What facilities, right?
Mr. Mayor, since we are the host of the Asian Para Games, so it is rather illogical to send as many athletes because we are the host, we don't have to spend money. So are we complete in all equipment sports?
We're going to have some challenges when it comes to the team sports. For example, I think football, five-a-side for those with visual impairment, is a challenge. We're trying to work with the Football Federation on this so that we can put the team up, but it might be difficult. City volleyball is another team sport that we're preparing for. And I think we will be prepared for wheelchair basketball. Like I said, Thailand and Malaysia are very strong. And I think we will work hard to be able to try to move the goal this time in 2020. So yes, we will try to beat as many athletes as possible in as many sports the next games. I don't know if Rob would you like to add to it, Rob? Rob is in the 20th.
So I got one last question.